fight. Jealous Iwe Zumi. Iwe Zumi had just returned home from a gym session with Tanaka. They were both basically obsessed with getting fit at the gym so they would always go together. He threw his gym bag onto the ground and took his shoes off before walking exhaustedly towards the living room. After plopping down on the sofa in relief, he looked around the room for his boyfriend. Surprisingly, the home was quiet. Usually, his boyfriend would greet him excitedly at the door. "Where's Kawa?" He walked over to their bedroom door, which was closed. He doesn't usually leave the door shut. Iwe Zumi placed his ear against the door in an attempt to listen to what was going on. He didn't hear anything. "What am I doing right now?" He decided to just open the door. This caused Oikawa to be startled by his sudden appearance. "Iwa-chan, I didn't hear you get home." Oikawa scurried over to his muscular boyfriend and gave him a big hug. Iwe Zumi, who was confused, hugged him back. "Watch the hair. About that, why are you doing your hair at this time?" "I got a sponsor for my social media account. It's a beauty face mask product and I have to take a picture and post it." "So why do you have to do your hair?" "Well, I just wanna look nice for the photos. Aren't you proud of me?" "I am, baby." Iwe Zumi placed a kiss on Oikawa's cheek. "But I don't think it's necessary to get this cute for a photo. The comments are always complimenting you. Isn't that the point?" "It's annoying though. Don't tell me, you're jealous?" "TCH, aw, poor jealous Iwe Zumi can't handle others calling his boyfriend hot."
"Don't call me that."
"What? Jealous?
Iwe Zumi.
Sorry, I meant to say Iwa-chan. Anyway, I have photos to take." Iwe Zumi rolled his eyes and sat on the bed as he continued to watch his boyfriend finish doing his hair. A few minutes later, as Oikawa finished his hair, Iwe Zumi watched him begin to put on the mint-colored face mask for his skin. Oikawa started to take his first picture and Iwe Zumi realized that he wasn't wearing a shirt.
Whoa, put on a shirt at least yet?
What?
If I wear a shirt it will distract from my beautiful skin.
Your skin is a beauty only I must know.
PFFT, you're so funny today Iwa-chan.
Don't laugh at me, HMPH. Iwe Zumi pouted while Oikawa laughed at him and continued to take photos. As time went on, Oikawa noticed that Iwe Zumi placed himself in the back of every single one of his pictures.
Iwa-chan, you're messing up my photos.
TCH, what did I do?
I know what you're doing.
Why can't you just behave and let me do this?
Okay, how about this? You can do a couple's night theme or something. We can both wear the mask in the picture and we can wear cute pajamas or something, that way we are both satisfied.
How am I satisfied with that?
Fine, how about I do whatever you ask afterwards?
Is that okay?
Yes.
Then can you do my nails for me for the picture?
That will be so cute.
Fine.
You know I can't do them right.
It's okay because I will force you to.
They both got prepared for the couple photos that they planned to take.
For the pajamas, Iwe Zumi decided to throw on a regular hoodie while Oikawa put on an alien nightgown that he bought. Oikawa also redid his face mask since it began to dry up and he applied the same mask to Iwe Zumi's face while he began to do Oikawa's nails.
This is so fun. I'm glad you came up with this idea, babe.
Yeah, sure. Let's take the photos already.
Okay.
Say cheese.
Oikawa was successful in taking his photos for his sponsor and Iwe Zumi was successful in calming down his jealousy. Oikawa never cared that his boyfriend became a bit possessive when he got jealous because he found it cute. He knew that they had a healthy relationship with each other and that they both loved each other. The end.